Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Losers Bracket Finals of War for the Thunder Cup. My name is Michael Zboom, and I'm joined here by the lovely, the Orange Doom. Wait.
Hello.
Hello, he says. Would you present yourself a little bit more? How's your Coke situation today?
Today I've run out of Coke, I've run out of Fanta, and I now have to resort with good old beer. Who doesn't like beer? Come on.
Beer? That is quite a ballsy move. Are we going to see some drunk streaming today? Yes, I can already see the manly chest hair sprouting out of your face for some reason. Don't ask me, I've never studied biology. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, especially ladies, how are you doing? Today's match is between Arcade and Fink. These two teams have faced off against each other before, with Arcade taking the win and pushing Fink right into the loser bracket. So this is going to be a very interesting match. They're going to face off against each other in revenge. Now, Orange, what is your prediction for this match here?
Well, based on yesterday's performance of Arcade, and based on the fact that I have to be a little bit biased towards Fink, my predictions are that Arcade's air superiority plan might start crumbling, hopefully.
Let's see now. Yesterday, in the winners bracket finals between Verve and Arcade, Arcade took a heavy 3-0 loss. I'm sure that some heads were bashed in yesterday, so let's hope that the teams this time are more prepared.
Hopefully. Because both of us, I think, enjoy the complete wipeouts of games, but yesterday's one came as a complete surprise. I mean, Arcade was the one dominating in the past matches, and then there came Verve and just completely wiped the floor with them.
Yeah, I've never seen a final go by that quickly. Like, when does that ever happen? Seriously. Arcade, get your stuff together. Anyway, these two teams are very, very strong now. Fink Squadron, also a very strong team. They've won everything up until now, except for Arcade. They lost once against Arcade and just dominated everything, just kicking out GOF yesterday. If you saw yesterday's stream, they had no mercy. They just kicked GOF's ass right into the ground. No questions asked. Sadly, GOF is now out of the tournament, and I'm a bit sad about that. GOF was kind of my secret love. I really like those guys.
Aww.
But hey, at least Orange can now face for his, he can now root for his favorite team. As we all know, Orange Doom is a Fink spy.
Yes, they know all the tactics now.
indeed, he's relaying the secret information he sees on the stream and is getting paid in gallons and gallons of coke. I think one of your life goals was what? 11,000 liters of gold? What of coke?
Gallons
of coke. That's it.
What are liters? Liters are like pennies for the poor.
Strong imperial system. Welcome. I should get with an American accent. America, best America.
I'm gonna tell you this. I just visited a Chinese restaurant with my dad, thinking, you know, I have about 1 hour of time. I just get some soup, you know, and some noodles. And as we pull up, there's a bus. A bus filled with Chinese people that are tourists going to visit a Chinese restaurant in a foreign country. Somebody explain that to me.
I don't know. That,
I mean,
does sound
who
very
comes
strange
to a foreign land and then eats their own food and their own, you know, restaurant? It's not going to be like home, you know?
Well, maybe that's the point here. I mean, if I'm going to China, I would really like to visit a German bar just to see what the differences are. It's probably going to be horrible, but hey, you never know.
Your beer's disgusting.
Ah!
A refund.
This is a offense to my people. Get down.
What is Wasser? I want beer.
Get out. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, if your eardrums just exploded, file your complaints over to the Gaijin forums. Actually, don't. They have nothing to do with this. This is all on us. Deal with it. Now, as we are speaking, the teams are trying to figure out some stuff here. Apparently, the first map is going to be Poland. Oh, yeah. Oh,
interesting,
yeah.
Interesting choice. It's not Eastern Europe. Actually, we haven't seen Eastern Europe in a while again. I feel like I'm going to jinx it again.
We haven't. No. We haven't. Yeah, it seems like the teams have heard our complaints. They went for more different maps. We complained that there was always Eastern Europe, Poland, and Berlin, right? So they went ahead and went with Normandy. Yesterday, we actually saw two matches on Normandy. What else? Well, Finland, sadly, is not one of the maps available.
Is Kuban in the maps?
I don't think it is, no. As far as I'm aware, the only maps allowed are Eastern Europe, Ash River, Poland, Berlin, and Normandy.
And Karelia.
And Karelia, exactly. We've not seen anything other than that. Oh, this is delicious. I have some family over. And they brought me some of those Kinder Choco ones. Little
oh my god,
things.
You bastard. I want some of that now. Oh, the chocolate goodness. It just melts in your mouth. I mean, they do know how to make chocolate, these people.
And diabetes. Oh. Lots and lots of diabetes. But hey, just to make you even more mad. Just to make you even more mad. I have so many of them, I even put them in my coffee. Because why not?
I will find you. And I will take that from you. You will never see it again. And then I will get diabetes.
Oh, did I tell you about the time I had 2 kilograms of Nutella?
Oh my god.
Ladies and gentlemen, someone must open a Kickstarter here. Actually, a donation. Let's open a donation fund here. Donate 11,000 gallons of Coke and 11,000 kilograms of Nutella to the Orange Doom. Make his dreams of being a human rolling ball of fat true. Make them become reality.
The brown goodness of chocolatey.
That sounds slightly orgasmic here. Kids, cover your ears. But yeah, actually, I'm joining you here with beer. I went with some very interesting Dutch beer, which is kind of weird. It is very, very, very different from Portuguese beer. But anyways, let's get into the game. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the first round of the Loser's Bracket Final. Arcade versus Fink. Whoever loses this one is out. Whoever wins this one is going to face off against Verf tomorrow in the Grand Finale.
Baru Baru!
Nah, this is the Baru map. Trees. This is the Baru map. This is the Stalinwood trees. Da, comrades. Strong Stalinwood trees. Just look at the consistency of that beautiful tree. Look at those leaves. So
beautiful
many of they have the many of pixels. Very good pixels. There. So Orange, how's the loadout looking? What are teams like now?
Well, Chippy and Fumu got bombs on. Chopstrotter is in fighter mode, and same story repeats for Arcade. Two fighters with bombs and one fighter with fighter duties.
Indeed, and even the exact same fighter series, we see one LA7, one P63 C5, and one BF109 G6 on each team. And the BF109
is blind Arcade, is heavily relying on those Shermans.
They are. You know what, I would assume that Arcade is going to go for B. That has proven very, very efficient. You know how we always said that the best way to win this map was to go for the CD, capture A and C,
yep,
because they are much easier to defend from, well, to reach from one side to another? Apparently not. Every single time I've seen a wipeout on this map, it was with a team taking B and then taking A and just holding it for the rest of the match. As soon as you have B and A, you win the game pretty much. You are almost impossible to take out.
Well, as long as you don't have two people sitting at C just, well, drinking tea and playing poker.
Oh, that's a stab at... Who was that? I think it was Arcade, wasn't it? Yeah.
It was Arcade, yeah. It was Nosok and Ilya.
They were just reuniting for a game. They are best buddies. Anyways, as we are talking here, we see a massive air battle here. I don't even know what's going on.
Enrikad's left wing is gone. Clean off.
That's a massive hole in your left wing. Ubochik also took out Futo from the other side of the river. Molcat lost lots of his aircraft. That's a big fire there. That's a very
not
big
looking
fire.
Good for Arcade.
Indeed, Fink is taking the air superiority here, it seems.
And they still have the bombs on, which is a huge advantage.
Yeah, Fink has not lost anyone yet.
Nope.
Let's see how the situation is developing here in the battlefield. Now, let's see. Alright, so we have...
And Red Dragon's Avar down.
Oh yeah. So we have Avar and Futil here, fighting up against Modern OT and West Kaneki, trying to go for B. Futil is in trouble though. He is repairing, which is not very good for you. So Avar, he's just bouncing shots with his frontal turret. He's taking some damage to the gun barrel and cannon breach. Oh, that was a massive hit. That's just his gunner and his loader down. That's going to take him some time here. This is not looking for Arcade. Arcade is not advancing too well over here. Meantime in the city, Fink took the A flag, Arcade took the C flag. So up until now, no ticket bleed. Scores are still even. Nosok and Ilya just capping it out here. Not so close like last time, just no Brokeback Mountain action going on here, but Nidar, Ubojik and Dirtar, but they're just waiting for the guys over on B to decide the match. And it looks very good for Fink. Fink are now advancing over on the two guys that are repairing. This is not looking good for Arcade.
Again, why are Ilya and Nosok just not moving?
Their love is too strong, Orange. No, you reach a point where you just can't. You just can't think about moving. You just can't stay far away. I mean, look at them. Look at them. They're just guarding each other here.
It's
Nosok
like Titanic.
Looking towards the Nosok here, angling his arm, looking towards the street over there. And Ilya McClam with a perfect view of Nosok's ass. I mean, look at that. Look at that sexy Sherman ass. Oh.
Ooh, Avar and Futil are being pressed down by Modern OT and Bass Panicky.
Indeed, it's not going good for them, but props them, they are still alive, they are still alive. Now, Futil took another hit to... Actually, he's still able to fire here. Oh, that's a hit. Took out the gunner of Modern OT, it seems. Let me check.
Yep.
Ooh, take a massive hit in return, though. This is not looking too good here. Now, here's the power of the Shermans. These guys are just using the very strong frontal turret armor, the very strong gun depression to just bounce shots all day, every day. And what's the 76mm on these tanks is quite a force to be reckoned with. They don't do much damage, but they have lots and lots of penetration. They still have trouble to penetrate the front of the turret of those guys.
Ilya and Nosok still sitting still, not doing anything. In the meantime, Angry Cat is slowly pushing forward, and he's about to meet Uboitsa. T-44, go down.
Let's see how this is going here. Ubojik is still guarding the defensive position here. They are playing very defensive here. You know, this is something I've seen at the start of this tournament. The teams were just going balls in, just not a care in the world, just rushing in, taking the win in less than 15 minutes sometimes. And now we see both teams playing very, very defensively here. Nobody in the city is even moving as long as the guys over on the B flag aren't resolving the situation.
Since the planes were eliminated, there's been no kills. Oh, never mind. Vest Panicky and Modern OT are gone.
Oh,
that was unexpected.
Oh, that's a massive turnover there. That was like two kills in the space of 3 seconds?
Yep.
This is going to prove a major advantage over to Arcade here. They have now free reign over the B flag. Which is going to prove some trial for Dirt Trouble here. Dirt Trouble is just...
Ooh.
Just
the left air is moving. Ilya and Nosok are in movement.
They are. They're just coordinating the attack here. This is going to be a perfect pincer movement. Look at this. Futil and Avar are going for B. Dirt Trouble and Ubojik are now being flanked from all sides. Three different sides. If the guys over if their teammates don't come fast, don't come to support them, they're going to have some... some surprise reaction ahead of them.
I think Thing is gonna have to go for Z here, otherwise, you know, trying to capture B is gonna be a hard one.
It is, but even if they capture C, they have to defend A and capture C, that's the thing here. If they manage to defend A, they might still have a chance here, but it's going to be very, very hard to do that. Just look at the force here. We have three guys from Arcade just surrounding. Oh, Ubojik is taken down by an Angry Cat. Ubojik had no way to face his turret. Dirtrouble are trying
to find out what Chippy is doing, because he's flying at 2,000 meters, just circling above the enemy airfield.
And he has a bomb.
Yeah.
I'm guessing some energy tactics here. He's probably waiting for the order of his captain to drop in and take out one specific, very, very dangerous tank. Because at the moment,
drop the bomb.
Drop the base. This is the thing, they just know Dirtrouble is about to die as well. This is not that they don't have a chance to hold this city.
He bans that one.
Come on, Trouble, come on. Take it from behind. Take it from behind, you're still alive, you can still fire. Come
you
on!
You can do it.
Takes a shot with Lee, but strong frontal armor of the M4. And now he's doomed.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do there.
Nothing you can do. So we are 8 minutes in and this is looking very, very strong for Arcade. They have all 3 flags. They just took out Dirt Trouble. Fink is now completely, completely pushed back into the spawn. And they are in trouble. Here's the strong power of the B flag. Look at that. They can just snipe them. Arcade can just snipe these guys while they're trying to cross the field from their spawn point. They're just getting spawn camped right now.
Hopefully Chalkstraw and the Tiger E can do something. It's his territory. Long range shooting should be his upper side.
Oh, look at the sneaky Obujike. Look at sneaky Obujike. He's going for C. He's decapping C. But it is not enough. They are still missing 2
panic
flags.
Is down.
Just look at this. Just look at this. Arcade is really... They are really making their names to use. Arcade applying arcade tactics. Ladies and gentlemen at home, you probably see this type of gameplay in your everyday play. Spawn camping all day, every day.
Boomer has now spawned in the A7 with bombs on, he's taken off in the airfield. I still don't know what Chippy is doing.
He's just biding his time here, but this is bad, because here's the thing. As long as these guys are in the air and not employing their bombs, they are useless. It's literally like as if Fink has one less player.
The only guess I can make is that he's waiting for tanks to accumulate in the same space to make at least two kills at the same time, but
maybe,
there's still those two Oswins, the Oswin and the M19 on the ground, you know, he can't get anywhere close there, so we'll see.
The thing is, these guys are no better than to budge up. I think the only time we saw a double kill was with the TBF on C from... I think it was GOF, wasn't it? Yeah, GOF actually taken out for the first time in the history of Thunder Cup. Well, that's not too bad because Thunder Cup is only in first edition, but hey, bear with me. The first time of the edition of Thunder Cup, they actually went with an aircraft, taking out a TBF. And Psalm getting a massive, massive double kill. Oh, just look at this, look at this.
Bombs are off, he suicided into Avro and... Yep, he takes him down.
He was very honorable. Look at that fire. And, yeah, that's one less Sherman, but they still have Futil over here. Even with one less Sherman, they are still playing very strongly. Now, Futil is in trouble. Look at the damage on his tank. Look, this is not looking good for Futil, but still. He doesn't need to move. He has all the time in the world.
Take him down. Arcade is standing strong. A and B are going to be hard to get by.
Indeed, look at this, look at this. Look at Arcade, look at this perfect C. Look at this. 4 tanks holding A. 4 tanks holding the front line and another one on the other side. Now Futil is in trouble, he seems to be on fire. Yes, he was on fire, he just... Or was he? Well, he might have been. Anyways. Yeah, these guys are just defending the city over here. There's no way for Fink to advance now. I think this game is pretty much decided. Unless some kind of miracle happens. And Chippy and the P63 somehow takes out a nuke. In a P63 and takes out half of the map. Fink are not going to win this one.
He's waiting for the bombs to accumulate.
Yep. Oh, dude, imagine a nuke in War Thunder. That would be amazing. Tactical nuke incoming!
Okay, Fink is now pushing forward.
I mean, Arcade doesn't even need to move, they're just holding the defensive position here.
Yeah. They're in perfect positions.
Fink is already half of the points down. 11 minutes into the game, this is not looking too good here. Wish he could take some fire from the artillery there, but nothing too bad. He survived that. Now, Fink are trying to advance here, but look at Martin OT, he's trying to advance. But he's taking fire from behind. Where did Zephyr shot come from? I should know. Oh no, it's from Futil over on the other side. Martin OT's not
looking
good
here. You just can't make it by. Norsog's there, there's Futil on the other side of the river, or the lake. There's no way.
This is nothing good. Martin UC is now immobilized, still in the line of fire of Futil over on the other side of the river. Takes another hit. Bounces it seems, but... I'm just what can the guy do here?
Arcade. Angry Cat is down.
Let's look at
this. And meanwhile, Chippy is still chipping time away.
Yes. I'm not exactly sure what kind of tactic they're trying to employ here, but in the time he's been flying around here, he's actually nowhere near the map at the moment. In the time he's been flying around, he could easily dropped a bomb, reloaded, dropped another bomb, and maybe even reloaded it again. He could have taken two tanks out by this time.
Ooh, heavy hit there. Oswin takes down Dotro.
Oh, Oswin's MVP. The Oswin is MVP. Look at this.
Oh, engine's down. Uber Eats is in damage.
Oh, Oswin is just wrecking this T-34.
Going. He's going ham. Oswin, he's down.
M19, actually, Malt catch him. D19 steals the kill there. Oh my god.
Triple A. Oh, Chippy's moving. Chippy's going in. And he's firing shells randomly.
Carshardt is trying to angle his armor, but he's down. He is down. Chippy now the only player left alive on Fink. Oh my.
What is he doing now?
Alright, so unless he can somehow take out the entire enemy team with a single bomb drop, then land his PTC-3 on the field and somehow roll over to B and cap it. Nope, he doesn't even try.
Chippy bailed.
That was not very spot.
They've given up.
Come on. I would have
expecting a bit more from Think.
I actually forgot to ask you guys at home. Ladies and gentlemen, tell me in the Twitch chat, what is your favorite team? If you've been following these guys, if you've been following this tournament, you know how these teams play. So what? Who are you rooting for? Tell me. And that's the 104 Arcade Esports. Now, if you just tuned in, welcome to the Losers Bracket Final of Thunder Cup. Today's match is Arcade versus Fink. Now, Fink already lost once against Arcade before. Arcade is the reason why Fink is in the Losers Bracket right now. And they are not going to get another chance. Here's the thing. Whoever loses this battle is out of the tournament. No second chances. Actually, no third chances. These are second chances. So, whoever loses this one is out, and whoever wins this one is going to face off against Verve tomorrow for the grand finale of Thunder Cup. And whoever wins tomorrow is going to get flown out to China to face off against the best Chinese team for a prize pool of $11,000. And your parents never said you would make any money playing video games. Well, there you go. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to make money, play War Thunder. Actually, you don't. I've been playing War Thunder for 2 years now.
Life
and
advice?
I haven't made any money.
You should consider it.
Yeah, generally you don't want to follow my life
Poland
advice.
Wow. Interesting. So Think losing on Poland decides to choose Poland. Ballsy move.
Here's the thing. I have seen this before. Teams have turned around to matches on the same map before. I think it was GOF versus... who was it? Might have been Mist? It might have been GOF versus Mist. Where GOF lost on Poland, Mist went ballsy, chose Poland again, and GOF wrecked them completely. No mercy. So maybe we see something similar here. Who knows? Now hopefully this time Chippy actually does something. He was not,
indeed.
He was not a part of that team. Now, of course, I can't say anything because I'm not in the chairs with him. So it might not have been Chippy's fault. It might have been the team leader that literally ordered him not to intervene, to try and wait. But they waited too long. They left the opportunity open for a kid to take the win.
Yeah, some people in the chat are speculating he was using his plane for spotting, but you can't actually spot tanks anywhere above 1 kilometer. So
yeah, you have to fly very, very low.
That was the case.
And even so, the tanks that are in light of sight can see each other. So there's and much further away. I mean, the guys on the other side of the river or in the other side of the lake can easily spot the guys in the town. So that's not a problem. So yeah, I don't know what kind of tactics they were, but it didn't work out. So let's hope that they use some different tactics here. But yeah, as you said, ladies and gentlemen, the clutch moment was really the taking off B. If Fink didn't lose that battle, that 2v2 battle over on the B flag, this match would have gone very, very differently. Now the teams are readying up. Yeah, it seems like Fink is ready. Arcade is also readying up, ladies and gentlemen. Again, this is Thunder Cup, finals of the losers bracket. It's currently 1-0 for Arcade. Arcade versus Fink. And these teams have to fight. This is their last chance to get into the grand finale, to face off against Verve. This is the second last chance to get $11,000. If they lose this one, they're not coming back. They are out. They are out of the tournament. Match is starting in 5 seconds. There we go. Now, gladly, we are going to see the fine Polish Stalinwood trees again, comrades.
Yes, comrades, the best trees in the world.
Best trees in the world. The Stalinwood tree is so strong, we make aircraft out of them. The Stalinwood tree is so strong, we put log on SU-85 to give better protection.
Tank now invincible.
So let me just quickly fix the scores here. Orange, your time to shine.
Okay, so we're waiting for them to spawn in. I think we're probably going to be seeing the same tactics here, and hopefully Chippy does something, not just fly around at 2k. LA7, BF19G for Arcade so far. Yep, three aircraft, looks like the exact same situation. Arcade is going with the Shermans, I think. Yep, Chippy, Chopstrotter, Fumu, exact same situation, except for this time we see Best panicky in the Panzer 470. Ooh. Interesting, interesting tactic.
Oh, and with my favorite camo. Oh, I love this camo. Seriously, this is one of the best camos you have in Warfinder. Just beautiful.
Oh, like a tiger.
Indeed. It's like a mini tiger. It's like a tiger cub. Just beautiful. Actually, I think the mouse gets the same camo, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know, the same.
Oh, well, no, I don't have it yet. I'm a scrub.
Orange Doom, you are a scrub, as you just said.
Hey, but I do have all planes, so yeah.
Now, let's see how the switch is developing here. What's happening here? Again, it seems like the same exact lineup, with the only difference that Fink apparently spawned on the other side of the map this time.
Yep, and Chippy has dropped his bomb. Wow.
Hold on, I have to fix these scores again. Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. Warfinder likes to randomize these team spawns, and then I have to fix the hub. Yay.
Trotter is engaging Angry Cat with his LA7. Fumu's diving down as well. Angry Cat hit, and left wing is gone again. Poor Angry Cat, he just can't get a break.
You've got a hole in your left wing!
Oh, great reversal. Moldcat is in trouble. VF19, come on.
Missed all of his shots though. Moldcat just evades that.
Moldcat suiciding and nope, that one didn't hit.
Ooh, Koth just left
wing's gone.
That's more than one hole. Ow!
They do love left wings today.
Indeed. As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, the best tactic for taking out enemy
aircraft. Red Dragon, right wing gone, he's out.
Going for the wings. Alright, same with SU again. Hold on. This is interesting. Fink, Best Panicky actually going with the Panzer 470 on B. A tank destroyer on B. This is a very interesting development here. Now, the Panzer 470 has some decently sloped frontal armor with 80mm of armor thickness, but it doesn't have a turret. And the gun repression isn't anything spectacular either, so it's going to be very interesting to see what he can do against the two Shermans here.
The only thing we need right now is for their aircraft to cover B, get B captured, and then just hold onto that, and they've got the game in the bag.
Indeed. Whoever takes the B flag first is probably going to win this, unless they get eliminated, but we haven't seen much in the way of eliminating today. These teams are definitely playing for the capture. We haven't seen a single GOE-D7 or TUF-1C. We haven't seen those yet. Oh. Yeah, Fink going for the caps here. What is Arcade doing? They are very defensive today. Fink actually just captured A, they captured C.
The flak is opening up heavily.
If Arcade doesn't do something very soon, they're going to have a fight here. They are already bleeding points quite heavily. That's at least
seems like a complete opposite match than what we saw last time.
Indeed. Fink starting out strong, but then again, we've seen reversals before. Now these guys aren't even moving. Modern Routine and Best Panicky aren't even moving. Avro just hiding behind the house, literally here in the middle of the other field, but very well covered from Modern OT's gun here with the hill in the way. So yeah, very defensive play here. Not much going on at this moment. Ooh, Ubushige facing off against Angry Cat. Takes a shot. No damage yet. Angry Cat is reloading, it seems. He must have missed his shot. Takes a hit. Angry Cat takes it. That's a track damage, but did not take the track down. Angry Cat is still mobile. Fires off a shot to switch his ammo type, it seems.
Ooh, door drop. Door drop with the engine hit there. He's on fire.
Oh, look at these guys. Ubushige and Angry Cat just playing cat and mouse around the star. Oh, but here we go. Door drop takes it, but Angry Cat is
on fire again.
Not fighting.
A shot.
Ubushige hits him right in the turret ring. That's a dead gunner and a dead turret ring. Ubushige has the advantage here, but Ilya McLaren is behind him. He cannot advance. Another critical hit. Ooh, Ubushige just take a fire in return, but nothing critical. Angry Cat is in trouble here. Angry Cat is in trouble, and Angry Cat is down. Massive play by Ubushige here. Now, how is Dirt Trouble doing? Dirt Trouble is repairing. He only took an engine hit. He still has all of his crew alive. Ilya McLaren has a trouble here now. He has to face off against two tanks on this corner. Playing very defensively, trying to angle his armor, but there's Dirt Trouble on his left side. Oh, takes a hit. Nothing major. Ilya McLaren takes a hit to the driver and the turret ring. Ubushige flanking around. Is he? Yeah. Ubushige flanking around and destroys Dirt Trouble. No, Ilya McLaren, sorry about that. Ilya McLaren is down. Fink taking the town.
Meanwhile, best panic in Modern OT and Avar. Ooh, Fumu just came in. Avar is down. Great bombing drop there. The LA7 is a hard one to do that in.
Perfect. Look at that fire. That was beautiful. Futile all alone now.
Futile doesn't hold on.
Oh, this is nothing good. Futile is the only player alive at the moment on Arcade's team. Yep. What happened?
Not looking good for Arcade.
There
actually,
we go.
Futile is the last remaining player Arcade has.
Oh my holy mother of God.
I did not see this one coming out. Futile's down. It's all over.
It's all over now. We are only 6 minutes into the game. What happened here?
I don't even know. When did they lose so many tanks?
I don't know. Holy crap. Okay, I'm out of words now. I was not expecting this.
Did you fall asleep in between and something happened?
I must have blinked.
Wow.
Damn. Okay, I must say here, Fink very much just turned this completely
they
around.
They thought this true, didn't they?
They did. Okay, so now what I'm asking is, what were they doing in the first match? Why didn't they do this the first time around? What did they do differently for the result to be completely different now? They just took out Arcade in less than... What, that was 6 minutes? They took out the entire team in 6 minutes.
There was no cap circles, there was barely any flanking game. It was just over. If Think can replicate this, they've got the files in hand.
Well, it's a bit early to say that just yet. Remember, it's only 1-1. The teams have to win 3 games in order to advance here.
True, but we have to stay biased.
Ah, you Think spy. Get out of here. Get to the chopper. Lol. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, hopefully you are enjoying the stream at home. If you just tuned in, welcome! My name is Mike Gillsboom, and I'm joined by the lovely Tim, also known as the Orange Doom. We are your commentators for today in the finals between Arcade and Fink. Now, whoever wins this battle is going to go up against Verve tomorrow in the grand finale for a chance to fly to China, face off against the best Chinese team, and win $11,000. And key typing. Ladies and gentlemen, mechanical keyboards.
Oh, you wish this was a mechanical keyboard.
It is not. It sounds like one.
Really? It sounds like... You sure?
It kind of does.
I would hope that's a mechanical keyboard. Actually, this one is... I've had it for about 3 months, and it's already so moist that it's starting to make crippling noises. So, yeah, I'm going to have to replace it soon. With hopefully a mechanical keyboard.
Oh, we all
with shiny
like
lights
moist
and stuff.
Very moist. Well, that's what you get for spilling coke all over it.
Oh, it seems like Chippy has now messaged us on the in the chat, and he's saying that he actually didn't have the bomb. So when he was actually circling, he didn't have a bomb on. It appeared to have been a glitch. If that's the case, then I don't blame him. He didn't really have much to do.
Well, that was very strange. I mean, we saw the bomb in the replay, so I have no idea what's going on there. Damn. Anyways, the next map is going to be Berlin. And ladies and gentlemen, if the stream suddenly interrupts, it's normal. Berlin always gives me a crash. Just, it's guaranteed. It is as certain as death in Texas. Crashes on Berlin.
Comrade. They cannot handle Berlin.
Berlin is too strong map. It's just fine German engineering. Actually, I should talk in a German accent. Yeah, Berlin is sehr gut.
Yeah.
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 Anyways, match is starting in 30 seconds. It's currently 1-1, Arcade versus Fink. Now, whoever takes this match is going to have a major advantage here. Berlin is quite a tough map. We've seen some major, major, major battles here. Some very heartbreaking moments as well.
Yep. And what we saw yesterday, for example, was unbelievable. It kept breaking. They just kept coming back. Verve just kept coming back.
Oh, you have no idea, dude. The matches on Berlin yesterday were so intense that they even got two crashes in one single match. That's how amazing that was. Anyways, yeah, battle is starting. Here, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to round 3 of the match of Arcade versus Fink. Welcome to Berlin! Yeah!
And the German houses incoming.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful copied German houses. Every house looks like one another. There are no streets. There are street lamps illuminating fences for the cats to safely travel through.
Is this a Berlin Wall?
Oh god, don't say that. No. This is 1945, there was no Berlin Wall. Oh god. We just lost all of our German viewers right now. Just look at the
too soon
viewership getting cut in half. That's how we and see very similar tactics here, it seems.
Same tactics.
Same old tactics, no changes here. You know, this makes life as a commentator very hard. You can only repeat the same thing so many times before it gets kind of boring here.
Very true.
And of
Except
course
for Chippy. Chippy is this time not going with the P63, he's in the LA7.
Oh, indeed.
Maybe the British flags.
Maybe his P63 was, well, out of bombs. Actually, he's not even taking out bombs this time either. He's going for the pure fighter roll, trying to get some air dominance here. And then let's see at the situation on the ground. How's this developing? So, what do we have here? We have three guys from Fink's squadron going over to C. We have Modern OT all by himself trying to go for A. On the other side, we have two guys from Arcade going over to A. And Avro is on fire. Avro is on fire, so that's one less for the time that the Modern OT has to be worried about. Dirt Chopper providing some very, very good defensive fire today. Look at that. Cross map defensive fire. Give Modern OT the time to capture A. Very interesting tactics. You know, Nosok and Ilya McClellan.
Moldcat is down.
Ooh, what happened there?
Angry Cat takes the hit as well. Chop Shot is on fire.
Ooh, Cops is on fire and he's down. Ooh. I think he went for a Russian spy that was hiding in a building.
That leaves Chippy. Can Chippy hold on against two enemy aircraft? Ooh, Angry Cat's on his 6 now. He's in trouble.
Oh, look at this. Look at the battle on sea. Ubojika and Bespaniki trying to hold off against Ilya McClellan and Nosok. But Nosok is coming in from behind. Nosok with some surprise behind action and Ubojika is down. He could not take it. Bespaniki now all alone against two tanks from Arcade. Ilya McClellan and Nosok again. I'm telling you, these guys always play together. They are like brothers in arms. They never leave each other alone. McClellan took a shot from the side, but no damage. Bespaniki now desperately trying to take this flag, but he's not even in the cap zone, it seems. No. He's now moving into the cap zone to stop the capping, but he's all alone. And here's the problem now. This is the perfect
position. Nosok is flanking.
Yeah. Nosok flanking around. Ilya McClellan's still waiting. Bespaniki takes a shot from the side. Ooh, that's a dead turret ring. That's a dead Cambridge. That's a dead gunner. This is not looking good for Bespaniki. Oh, and Bess is down. Dirt Chopper did not come in time. He tried to help and give him some supporting fire, but it was not in time. Oh, look at Moldcat.
Oh,
we see the first TBF1C in this match today.
Here he comes.
Now he still has Shippy to worry
about. And Ilya are like the dream couple. They go everywhere together.
They are. They're the dream team. And now Modcat still has
beer and worst.
Modcat still has Shippy to worry about, but Shippy is in a battle between those two. Between the two other aircraft. So he has all the time in the world here. Modcat, he was going for a modding out, but did not have the Oh, that's a hit, that's a right wingtip gone. He still seems to be alive though. Can he recover? Oh, look at this. Perfect flying here. Look at these piloting skills. He's missing a major part of his wing, but he's still in the air somehow.
He's going into capture D here. You have to be careful, there is Modern OT looking over.
Oh yes, indeed, it's not looking good for him.
He doesn't have a clear shot, he's going to have to push himself. Oh, he gets hit there.
Namakot is still, yeah, this is amazing. Look at this. He's missing half a wing and he's still in the air trying to turn around, but it's going to be very hard for him to now precisely drop bombs. He lost almost all of the maneuverability of his aircraft.
Oh, Chippy's coming back. Chippy's on the sixth bomb. Angry Cat. Angry Cat's damaged. He's trailing
smoke. That seems like his engine is down. Angry Cat's engine is in trouble here.
Engine is orange.
Orange, you said?
He's in trouble.
Orange. The orange doom.
He's doomed.
He is doomed indeed. This is not looking...
Oh, yeah, that goes, like, yeah,
and
right
that's
wing.
A right wing gone.
Great shot.
Let's see how the situation is developing over here.
Oh, Modcat lost his tail.
Now, this is interesting. Even though they just lost their bomber, Arcade are very strong in the capture game here. They have C, they have B. They're holding it strong. Fink only has the A flag, with Modern OT not having moved since. Any seconds on fire there as well. Ooh, that's a major hit to his commander, it seems. But yeah, at the moment Arcade still has the advantage here. They just have to play defensive, and they can win by points here. Although, the scores are pretty even here. Ilya McLaren is trying to snipe Modern OT from across the map, but there's way too much clutter in the way. Avro is on the B flag, repairing. Someone just lost their track. I can see Dredgehog and Best Beniki are trying to flank around, but it seems like they're not exactly going for C.
Avro is on fire, and Avro is down.
Avro is down. B is now open for Best Beniki to take. Arcade all confined over on the C flag. This is not looking good for Arcade. They are about to lose their flag. Now Dredgehog and Dubushika are playing very defensive here. What are they trying to do? They have the numeric advantage here. But then again, we have Nosok over here, but Ubujiki could easily advance, easily get around, take out one tank, and then take out Ilya with a perfect pincer maneuver. They are just holding still here. But then again, they don't need to move. Here's the thing.
Utu just took a critical hit. Third ring is down. Modern Ulti has been camping on A and just doing spawn shots. Brilliant.
Spawn snapping all the way, and it paid off. They now have two flags. Fink just took the second flag. They just initiated the bleed over on Arcade. Now they are still down by scores, but they are about to even it out. And if they hold this for long enough, they're going to win this game. A Cutthroat here in the Ostwind isn't really doing too much. There are no aircraft in the air on the enemy team. Rechang also in an Ostwind, but then again, the AA are not very good. And they are about to lose C. Oh my god. Fink just went in. They just captured C. Yeah. Arcade
Fink
is
going
very
strong right now. Since that first match, they picked up things heavily.
Oh yeah.
Arcade now has two players that can't respawn anymore. The rest of them have their last life. Meanwhile, Fink still has four players that can die at least once.
Ooh, Angry Cat took a massive shot from the side there. What happened? Something is still okay though. But yeah, this is definitely looking like a very strong play from Fink. They have all the advantages here. They have all the flags. Here's the crash. Yay! AMD! And you're with the image again. There we go.
Yeah, Dr. Abanubu are still holding C, slowly pushing forward. The Bass, Paniki, and Fumo are pushing forward. But Modern OT is still heavily in A. Ooh, Futilich trying to swim across to B.
It's not going to be enough though, it's not going to be enough. They have to take out at least two flags here. The best that Futil can hope to do is flank around Best Paniki and Formu here. Try to take him from behind, try to surprise him. But still, yeah, it's but 1v2, and if he crosses that ridge, he's going to expose himself to Modern OT.
He has a bit of an idea where he's coming from. Yep, he's turning around.
Yep, he knows exactly where he is.
Bad timing.
But Futil has the advantage here, he has very strong turret armor, but he bounces! He bounces, he could not afford that bounce. He could not afford that bounce. He is now stuck here, he cannot advance. If he crests that ridge, he's going to be shot in the face by Fumio. And you definitely don't want to get shot in the face by a Russian tank.
Norsok is down again. He's out of the match.
This is not looking good for Arcade. Arcade having no
Arcade
flags.
Arcade running out of time, running out of points, running out of vehicles.
This is not looking good here. And I must say, I like the water effects here. Look at Futil's
driver is down.
Oh, Futil is down. Best Paniki flanks around to take Futil down.
Yep, Think has taken this one home big time.
Ladies and gentlemen, Think coming with the comeback. They lost the first match, but they took the next two. Incredible play by Think here. And Chippy suicides into his teammate. Very honorable. Tomb suicide is the best kind of suicide. So these scores are going very, very good here. Think taking the second win. This is unexpected and holy crap, Orange. Do you have any idea how many viewers we have at the moment?
It says 275, 287
now. Holy mother of God. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to ThunderCup.
We're breaking the records.
We are breaking records here. This is amazing. I mean, the fans were yesterday and we didn't even see that. But holy crap, everybody at home. Hello and welcome to ThunderCup. This is Arcade versus Fink. Whoever wins this match is going to face off tomorrow in the grand finale against Verve. We are your very sexy commentators. My name is Michael's Boom, and I'm joined by
Orange Doom,
also known as Coke Addict, the brown kind, not the white kind. Don't get your.
I didn't realize at this point that our actual names rhyme.
Indeed, you know, I said this before. We should create a hybrid channel, the Orange Boom. Mike goes Doom.
With the Mike Doom.
Mate, marry me.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
So how's the scores looking? Orange, how are the scores looking?
I think it's 2-1 if my math skills are anywhere on par.
Indeed. Fink here taking the epic comeback. Fink now leading 2-1. Now, this is a match point. This is the last chance for Arcade to turn this around. If Arcade loses the next match, they are out of this tournament. And you know, this is extra sweet for Fink. Not only are they currently winning, not only have they the best chance to take this and get to the grand finale, this is also a revenge match. Remember, Arcade was the team who won against Fink and put him in the loser's bracket. This is revenge best served cold.
Yep, and if I'm not mistaken, it's Fink picking the map this time around.
It might be, yes. Fink took the second map, so yeah, it should be them. Yep. It should be them, yeah.
That gives them a huge advantage. Hopefully it's not Poland again, or
really
Eastern Europe for that matter. I'd love to see some Corellia action. Corellia had some great counterattacks. You remember that Tiger E going to Cap?
Oh, I love that. I love that.
Unbelievable.
The battles on Corellia are always amazing. All those battles in the hills and in between the mountains, amazing stuff, I tell you. It's actually one of my favorite maps. Corellia was pretty much my favorite map right from the get-go, right? Since
one of the first maps to be introduced anyway, so...
Yeah. I still remember the camping spots there. Do you remember over on the spawn zones, on the eastern side, I think, where you can just get up a hill and just snipe the enemies all day long? I used to do that. I did that for days. Just camping, getting out with 20 kills per game. Hell, I didn't do anything for my team,
it was like a spot where I would drive the Ferdy, just sit it down and hold down, and nothing could pen you, just completely club their spawn point.
Ah, good times. But sadly, they changed the spawn points a little bit. It's not quite the camp fest anymore. And they removed the...
I agree every team.
But you know, I gotta give it to Gaijin there. That was a very good choice there, because the players were always just camping up there, and they were not going for the objective. I mean, there was literally no point to go for the objective. As long as you stood in that spawn zone, you're guaranteed to get at least 5 kills. It was just amazing times.
Yeah.
So let's see what the players in the what the people in the chat are saying here. Yes, this is live, and indeed there's a 2-minute delay. The delay being that the teams can't stream snipe each other. Yes, we are the smarts. Not really, but hey. We do have to take some precautions here. What else? We see lots of cats emojis, lots of kappas. Civilic thinks that Fink is going to win. You know what? I'm going to say they have a very strong advantage here. They only have one match to win. Arcade is to turn around.
And they have the map
now.
Choosing here.
And they have the map choosing here. Now, they still haven't chosen any map, which is weird. But yeah, it's going to be very interesting to see how this last battle develops.
I just realized something. Angry Cat, which is part of Arcade, which is also the leader of the Russian streaming part, is on Arcade Steam, and I'm on Thing Steam, and I'm doing streaming here. It's a bit of a counter.
Indeed.
And it's Poland.
Kind of a...
It's Poland.
Not Poland!
Oh, not again. We've had enough Stalinwood for one day, please, knock it off.
Yeah, comrade, I prefer going to Gulag than seeing any more Stalinwood.
There is more Stalinwood in Gulag, trust me.
Gulag is made of Stalinwood. Yeah,
Gulag
Stalinwood
is Stalinwood.
Selenium. It's very strong. It's very strong. Very strong.
Very,
place.
Very strong.
No, Poland, actually, you know, as sick as I am of seeing this map, I gotta say, Poland is one of the best maps for competitive matches. Just very much quite balanced. Well, except for all the spawn camping going on, but hey, you catch my drift.
It's nice because it's open. You got those three cap circles that aren't very close to each other, giving you some really, really nice action.
Yeah, there's some very varied action here. You got the city combat, and you got the wide open combat. Just, you get a little bit of everything. And both the aircraft have trouble, of course, taking out players in the city. They have no trouble taking out players over on the B flag.
30 seconds.
Indeed, Arcade is ready. Fink is ready, ladies and gentlemen. This is Thundercup. Arcade versus Fink. These are pretty much finals here. Whoever wins this one is going to go to the grand finale versus Verve. And holy crap, there's a lot on the line. There's a lot on the line. I would not want to be the fan of these
gallons
players here.
Of lot.
11,000 gallons of coke. That's how much is on the line here. Lots and lots of diabetes. And the teams are ready. We are going to start this match any moment now. Just a quick reminder here. Your lovely commentators you are hearing right now are Mike Goes Boom and Orange Doom.
And the Orange Goes Doom.
Oh, the Orange Goes Boom. And Mike is Doom. I don't know. You know what? People in chat, invent your own names for us. Type something. The Orange Broom, Mike Goes Vroom, I don't know. Give us some suggestions here.
Yes, yes.
Alright, match is starting in 5 minutes. Hopefully you guys at home are very comfortable. Have your pampers on, taking your pants off, and have a towel nearby, because this match is going to be exciting. I know, I lost my pants.
Yeah,
and Orange probably never
trees.
Had pants. Orange, do we even have pants?
Who needs pants?
Who needs pants? Pants are...
Real men
just
don't
a
wear pants.
Just a hassle.
Real men wear Stalinwood.
Duh. Hey girl, do you want to see my Stalinwood? War from the pickup lines. Okay, seriously, if this actually works, I'm claiming copyright here. Anyway, so once we have a lovely look at the Stalinwood trees here, we see, again, exact same tactics.
Yeah, best panic in the Panzer 470.
So we have Angry Cat and Mold Cat and Red Dragon in aircraft, B-49G6 without any bombs, LA-7 and PC-3 with bombs. On Fink we have Chippy, this time taking out the PC-3 with bombs. Hopefully he doesn't have the glitch again. We have... Best Paniki again in a Panzer 4 with the lovely, lovely, beautiful camo. Again going for what seems to be B. Yes, indeed. Okay, but here's the thing. From what I've observed so far, the people that spawn on the Western side have won. In the first map, in the first battle, Arcade spawned on the western side and they won the battle by taking B. Over here,
Chippy's bomb is gone, he's going fighter mode.
In the, what was it, second battle, third battle, Fink spawned on the west side and they won. And now Arcade spawned on the west side. So it's going to be interesting to see if they hold up the tradition and actually go for the comeback here.
Where's the boys, comrade?
Ooh, this is not looking for Arcade, look at that. Alvaro stopped dead in his tracks repairing. That's going to give him a major disadvantage here.
Because and he's all Mold alone Cat. As well. Moldcat's on fire.
Your plane is on fire! He's still flying though, he's still flying though. He's going to drop his bomb on Ubushika. Yes, 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 and suicides and takes out Ubushika! That's what I call being honorable.
That's a last ditch effort.
Oh yeah. As you can see, people, being on fire does not mean you're down.
Oh, Angry Cat's damaged.
He's fine, he's fine. It's just a flesh wound. So what do you see over here? Now, Arcade has the disadvantage here. Avar is the only one still left alive on the other side of the river, and he's being held down by Dirt Trouble and Ubojika on the other side of the map. He cannot advance right now. In the meantime, Modern AOT is going for the cap zone. Best Paniki is waiting for Avar to appear. They haven't seen those guys yet. So it's a very strong start for Fink here. They are the first ones to capture B, and if Arcade doesn't put some forces over here, they are going to have a major fight here. Not only do Fink have B, they also have A. Dirt Trouble took A. Ian McLaren is over on C, but it's the same
Nonsuch
situation
is
over
nowhere
again.
Close to Ilya. What's that? Is our favorite pair falling apart? They're having a crisis?
Indeed, I think they might be breaking up.
They're miles apart. It's now Scar Racer and Ilya. They're the new one.
What did we do?
I think
you broke them up. It's just some apology flowers. Anyways, back to the game. Yeah, it's looking very good for Fink here. They took both critical flags here. Arcade does have the C flag, but it's not enough. They have to have two flags in order to initiate the bleeding here. The only chance Arcade now have is to spawn in some bombers and going for the elimination. But that's going to be very, very hard. Very, very hard.
Cat is now chasing Fumu, they're the last remaining players, but Fumu is smart. He's carrying him over Chop Shore in his Osterin to take him down.
Oh, but Angry Cat skillfully evading here. He has some damage here. Oh, and he's on fire. He's on fire. Angry Cat is one hot cat.
And that was Modern OT. The Sherman.
Oh, Sherman's OP.
The freedom knows no boundaries.
Yeah, we seem to have some new relationship here. Ilya McLaren and Sky Racer are the new lovely pair of the Arcade team.
Yes,
Ilya shooting at Formu with this 50 cal. That's a bit far away though. Yeah, very static here, very static. Arcade are not advancing too fast here. Avro still held down behind this house here. He is in trouble.
It almost feels like the first game is happening over again, it's the teams are reversed.
It is. You know, this is sad to see here. I would hope for some action here, but these teams know what they're doing now. They are going all in. They're not taking chances here. They're playing as defensive as they can. And Fink doesn't have to do anything. They just have to survive.
I think chat is saying you forgot to change the scores.
Oh, sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, indeed, I did forget that. Hold on.
That's score bias.
Score bias. There we go. Now it's changed.
No, Osok is now going all alone towards A.
No, I don't know what to say about this. Is this not looking for good for Arcade? No, remember,
just
Arcade,
like Arcade is just kind of falling apart.
Yeah, they don't have the time, they don't have the luxury to just stay there inactive. Now they're going for a push over to A. But then again, here's the thing. A is very, very hard to take out. As long as the enemy team has some players on the other side of the river here.
I mean, Avro and Moldcat are trying to push towards B, but there's no way. Modern OT and Best Paniki will hold down. Modern OT is taking shots here. He's out in the open.
Yeah, he did take some damage to his gunner and his loader. But he's back up. No critical, not too critical damage. He's good.
Oh, Nosok, Skaris and Ilya are now together. Is Nosok going to get a little bit jealous?
Oh, Nosok critical hit against Dirt Trouble. Dirt Trouble is on fire.
Dirt Trouble's on fire, yep.
Now Sexy has to worry about the other guy on the other side of that house. But he's going for Dirt Robber here, he's going for Dirt Robber. Takes another shot, and Dirt Robber is on fire again. That's going to cost him some seconds trying to take the fire out. Dirt Robber takes another hit. This is not looking good for Dirt Robber. This might be the death of Dirt Robber.
And Uber to this
sets him, doesn't set him on fire this time. Does not set him on fire this time. But he knows. Oh, Dirt Robber is down. Dirt Robber is down. Nos again, she took him down there. Very good. Obushiki now the only player defending this flag. If Nosek takes this guy down, they are going to take this flag. And maybe turn it around. Maybe this was the tactic all alone. Just pretend to go for B, but in reality, go for the two flags in the city. Ooh, Obushiki's in trouble here, look at this.
Is getting sandwiched.
That's some sexy tank sandwich here. And he is down.
Down.
Arcade takes A. Chippy is the closest thing Fink Squadron has to the A flag, but he has four tanks to worry about. You know, they might just have turned around. They might just have turned this around. Arcade actually going for the strong cap here. It's going to be very hard for Fink to turn this around now. As long as Arcade holds
Chippy,
this.
Chippy is not in a good position. Angry Cat's gonna have a shot here. He's waiting.
Oh, Hero, where are you?
Hero, Hero! Baru, Baru! Baru, Baru! No Baroons yet.
Oh, we didn't see any Baroons today. That makes me sad.
Oh, Chippy's taking a heavy hit. He's on fire.
That's a massive smoke cloud over there. Let's look at Chippy. Yeah, there's nothing good for him. Chippy is... Okay, let's come to damage here. That's a dead engine. Dead commander, dead radio operator, dead track, he cannot move, he cannot move from here. He is screwed. Bounces off against the Angry Cat again. Illy McLaren coming from behind. We see a lot of surprise action from behind today.
Yep.
Look at that. Chippy sadly with his ass out. His ass is out in the open. That's another fire. And Chippy is down. You know, Orange, I think Arcade actually done it. They actually did it. They turned this around. They might just come with a comeback here.
Speaking of it, Dirt Robber is now capturing A or C.
Ooh.
There's Rank Dragon.
But Rank Dragon is only in an Ostwind.
Well, the Ostwind did take down two players last game.
It did, but here's the thing. From the side, it's another thing taking off from the front.
That's a different story. That's correct. Pumu is now pushing towards C as well.
Is Fink going to take this around now? Now, Fink has the advantage of having the B flag. They are kind of sandwiching the arcade here.
Interesting turn. Best Panicky is staying on the hill. Modern Ulti is going around the lake.
Now, Angry Cat is coming back for the C flag. They know that they are being decapped, but they're only a T-44 and an Oswin against two tanks. If they don't get lucky, they're going to have some problems here. Now, the bleed is initiated on Arcade again. Fink initiating the bleed here. Pom is also in the cap zone now. Red Dragon is in trouble here. Red Dragon is in trouble. He's trying to stay alive, trying to give him some support here. Oh, look at Angry Cat, come from behind.
Oh. Nope. Third ring is down, Fumu is in trouble.
Indeed, but he's behind the house. Angry Cat comes around. Fumu not taking the time to repair. He's taking as much cover as he can. Dirt Robber is aware. Dirt Robber is not aware. Critical hit.
Ouch, that one hurt.
That's a dead gunner, dead loader, dead everything. His entire turret crew is dead. But Angry Cat takes the hit as well. Nothing damage. Nothing critical though. That's Dimer only a driver.
Ilya coming in.
Oh, look at Ilya. Look at Ilya.
Ilya's protecting Angry Cat. He's just pushing forward. Wow.
Look at this. Look at this rush from Arcade. Look at this rush.
What
that's a Zerg rush.
Oh
my god!
Dirt Robber is down.
Oh my god, Fomu is in a world of pain right now.
Ilya's now on fire, god knows from what.
Fomu trying to defend the cap here, but
and
he is down.
Is down. Great push from Arcade.
Mother of god, but look at the Mario AT. Oh! And the entire Arcade team went for C, leaving A open.
Has a break. He's going for A, unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Look at these ninja tactics! Look at these ninja tactics! And here's
he
the thing.
All the way around the lake. All the way around the lake just to capture A.
Oh my god. And here's the
wow.
thing. They have the advantage here now. A is a much more important flag than C is. They can defend A from over from B, and given, Best Panic is the only player over on B, and he's facing off against Moldcat right now, but if he destroys Moldcat, he has the perfect, perfect line of sight over to B.
There's gonna be a time bomb here.
It is. Look at that, Arcade is half of the points down, they cannot afford to lose this flag.
There they come, Angry Cat, Sky Racer, Ilya, just moving like
again,
a little train.
Again, coming in force! Modern MG is going they're to have a massive fight here on his hands. He's going to have to fight off against 3 tanks. And they are running out of tanks here. Look at Fink. They are running out of
the
tanks here.
The problem is Best Panicky. Best Panicky can't protect him. There's still Moldcat there holding him down. Ooh, it's gonna be close.
This is intense. This is intense. Ladies and gentlemen, these tactics, these threats are just amazing. Game's being turned around by the mid. We are already 12 minutes into the game and a clear win is not yet announced. This is still anyone's game here.
Can Modern OT protect himself against 4 incoming tanks?
It's all down to it. Now Fink cannot afford to lose any more tanks. Look at the team lineup. They are down 2-1. Arcade has the numbers advantage here. They just have to rush. That's all they have to do. They just have to rush. Modern OT cannot afford to be taken down here. Yes, to defense flag. Look at the left side. Look at the flash flag.
Sky Racer again, like the happy pair they are.
Skyrest and Ilya coming from the left side. This is nothing good for Modern OT. How is Best doing? Best is still facing off against Moldcat. He cannot
Modern,
turn around.
He has to stay in the cap circle.
Yes, but look at this. Ilya McLaren is now coming from the front.
Oh, they're pushing him.
Modern OT just fired. Ilya McLaren takes his time. Tries to get around. Modern OT blocks him off.
They're both coming in force. Skyrest is coming from behind.
His cannon breach is down. Modern OT's cannon breach is down. No, and he's on fire.
He's on fire.
Oh no.
Oh my god, what is happening?
Look at this gangbang. This is a tank gangbang. From behind, from the front, from the side.
This is not safe for work.
Kiss, shoot your eyes. This was not pretty. Ow. I've never seen such a team playing for Arcade. They just rushed at. You know, do you remember those seagulls from Finding Nemo?
mine.
Oh my god. But Sky Racer is on fire, what happened there? Best Panicky actually, with a clutch shot, he took out. Best Panicky took out Modern OT, it seems.
He took out Moldcat before that and is now moving on towards Ken. I mean
he's trying
to take down all the tanks in A and then push forward. Chopsaw is going for C. Unbelievable. Look at them. Look at him go. Fink is just going ninja mode. They're going ninja mode. I can't believe it.
Look at the scores. If they can actually manage to hold C long enough, they might still win this by point because they're not going to win this by elimination. They only have 2 players left. Fink is running out of tanks here.
Yep.
If they could only spawn into an aircraft, a TBF 1C would be the perfect position right now. Let's see how fast they react. Let's see how fast Arcade reacts. They're now being capped. Yeah, Oswin is turning around. Ilya is turning around. They are all coming in full force now.
I might be seeing something wrong, but Modern AT should have at least another vehicle left.
He should. Maybe he's biding his time. He might be biding his time. Now, what did he take out?
Deciding whether to go with a tank or a plane.
No, an aircraft would be perfect now. Seriously, the best strategy right now would be to take out an aircraft and stop Arcade from advancing towards C. If they can hold C long enough, they're going to win this game. But it's only enough.
A TBF would be ideal, but the problem is that there is still Red Dragon in the game and he would be a very, very dangerous thing to come by.
Indeed. Now, what?
Oh, what has just happened?
What happened?
I don't know.
What just?
Mission is in progress. I don't know.
Okay, so either we just disconnected, or could it be that the game ran out of time there?
I don't know. In that case, who won?
I think it's saying GG, but okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are a bit confused here. Apparently, Fink won.
Wow, Fink has won.
Fink won. How? So that's what the ninja plays were all about. Oh my god!
Fink was playing ninja mode.
Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, let me explain this.
Wow.
apparently, the game timer was 15 minutes. And because Fink had more points at the end of this 15 minutes, despite having less tanks, they actually won the game.
Oh, wow. Wow. Unbelievable.
Okay, so that's a 3-1 for Fink. Fink moves on to the finals. Fink is going to face off tomorrow against Verve. Fink actually took the revenge against Arcade and took them out. Okay, that was a very strange way to win this one, but hey, I guess fair play, fair tactics.
I guess the ninja way is the way to win.
I was not expecting this. That was very unexpected.
Indeed. Both of us were just like, oh great, has it disconnected? Are we gonna have to do this whole thing all over again?
Oh, I would have died. Dude, we are already sprinting for 1 hour and 10 minutes. This was an intense final here. But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, at home, I hope that you enjoyed this as much as I did, as we did. We have been your hosts. My name has been Mike Gilsboom.
I've been the Orange Doom.
Oh yes, we've rhymed. I just love this. This melody.
We're the Rhyme Bros.
We're the Rhyme Bros. Oh yeah. Now listen, gentlemen. Tune in tomorrow at the same time, 8 p.m. CET, for the grand final between Fink and Verve. Now tomorrow is going to be the big game. Tomorrow is technically the last game of Thunder Cup, isn't it? Whoever wins tomorrow's game is going to go to China. This is big. This is big. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all very much tomorrow. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow. Meow.